Hey everybody, I'm Rick Beato. Today's tip of the day has to do with the diminished scale. In this case, it could be the dominant diminished or the tonic diminished scale. This actually can be used interchangeably. So on the guitar, the diminished scale is actually easy to use because every four frets it repeats. So if you're going to work on your chord voicing or chord scales, you can do really cool things just with a couple different shapes. For example, if I take an F sharp 7 chord, I can play this shape for an F sharp diminished 7 with a flat 9. And then I can go up to here, which would be an F sharp 13 flat 9, and then move up to here and repeat the shape. So this first shape, I'm moving it up 4 frets, and I'm going to the same shape that I did here. So I'm going there, 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 then there to there, okay? So I can also do it on the lower strings. And a lot of guitar players kind of avoid the lower strings, don't even think about where the voicings are there. So I'm gonna play a chord line for you here, starting on a low F sharp 7 sharp 9 chord. A lot of people don't play that chord voicing there, but it actually sounds great. And you can use voice leading, meaning using single notes to connect chord shapes. So I'm going to play a series of chords and connect them with single notes like this. I'm going to go there, so I'm going to go and add that third. You can see the F sharp 7 chord there, so it's going to go like this. Okay, so I'll play it slowly. I'm going F sharp 7 sharp 9, adding the third, and then I'm going to this shape here, which has the third, the flat 7, the sharp 9, and the fifth in it. And I'm going to add the 13th up here, right? So I'm going to go, and then I'm doing the same shape, but come back on it like that. And then I go back to the first shape. Play the same sequence. Check it out. Repeat. Repeat. Now I'm going to change the pattern a little bit and go up here to a, which would be E flat 13 shape, but it still works over this because those chords are symmetrical and it fits right in the pattern. I'm going to go. Here I'm going there, and I'm just adding that single note while holding the bass note down here. So I'm going then same single note. That's all for now. Please subscribe here to my Everything Music YouTube channel. If you're interested in concepts like this, check out my Beato book version 2.0 on my website at www.rickbeato.com. Thanks for watching.